disrespect that. That is our USP. That is our core strength. We should never lose that. Why Andhra people are doing well in USA? Again the same thing. In fact, a lot of USA Americans complain. There is a serious social disparity between us and them. They don't complain. Then they ask, what is the social disparity? If I go late to my home, my wife will divorce. But this Indian guy, Andhra guy, if he goes late, his wife will not divorce. His wife will still support and give him food. There is a serious social disparity. Why will you expect me to work like an Andhra guy? What will happen to me and my family? So that kind of social support system we have at our home. Even if wife works, husband also generally don't grudge. They should validate the statement, but generally they don't grudge. So there is a nice work culture in our state, we should not lose that. So with such wonderful people, and we can create wonders in our home. And this is the CSR award we got in the world. Yeah, thank you. This is about the port. Government strategy of going forward with a port development strategy is better. Right. At least 10 reasons you should speak about. One each. Why it is right, if it is right. Why should Andhra government, I am taking questions to you instead of taking questions from you, but that's okay. I take your questions also. Why should Andhra government adopt this port development strategy? If so, let's list out 10 reasons. I want one after the other, one reason at a time. Please, one reason. Very nice. Yes, one. Because all these things are covered during my speech also. So one is geographical advantage, certainly. Then second reason is employment opportunities. Yes. This I will explain a bit. If IT revolution is brought, what IT revolution has brought to Andhra is, I would call it essentially a middle class revolution. Anybody who wants to draw game books out of IT revolution, he has to become an engineer, he has to be a software expert. Otherwise you should be a cab driver or a hotel owner to feed them or to transport them, right? Rest is all IT jobs are all for elite or middle class. But a port-led development is, there's a job for a school dropout, there's a job for a villager, there's a job for a truck driver, there's a job for a management expert like you, there's a job for a maritime expert. And you know, again I tell, I explain, if once you bring 22 lakh tons of coal, it requires 10,000 trucks to take it out. Each truck, if a new truck comes onto the road, it creates 5 jobs. Right? You need 2 drivers, 2 cleaners per month, and 1 to repair on the roads or to feed in. The average 5 jobs are created. So if more cargo is coming into Andhra Coast, that means more jobs are created. Right? So huge number of jobs can be created by port development compared to any other type of development. Okay, that's a very good point. Second, third. Yes, rural development also happens. Because so far, like our, what did we learn out of Andhra Telangana division? We have kept all our eggs in Hyderabad basket. Hyderabad developed, but that created a lot of disparities. Without going into the political reasons, that created regional disparities. Right? Whereas a port cannot be in Hyderabad. Port has to be on the coast somewhere. Right? So the coast and the rural areas in the coast will always develop. Vizag, if you know, a few years back, there were so many small fishermen villages here. Even Rishikonda was also a small village when we were students. But because of the port and then industries and then other social services, social segments development, cities are growing, rural development is happening. Certainly that's also a point. Third.
Industrial development.
Industrial development, but it goes without saying, yes, industrial development also happens because many industries have raw materials to import or finished goods to export. So if you try to put in Hyderabad or farther places, you have a huge operational cost built into your products. So if you are close to the, as a supply chain expert, you should always advise, if you are close to the port, you are saving a lot of money on that. So definitely industrial development. Then,
fourth.
That's more marketing, direct benefits. Yeah, wealth creation, let's put it this way, wealth creation can happen which can lead to further development of the society through CSR. Put it that way nicely. Ports can create wealth, wealth can get dissipated and then that leads to development of the people. Right?
Then productivity improves. Is it right, sir? Can we take that as a factor? Or can we say more focused? AP started cultivating maize a lot. When we were kids, there was no maize in AP. In fact, we used to think always Punjab and other states will produce maize. AP can't produce maize. Today, AP is producing a lot of maize. Why? Why? Are we eating more maize? No. Actually, maize had a lot of buyers, world agri buyers like Topher, the Thar, and so many people have started their shops in India and they are buying maize. In fact, they buy maize from the farmer directly. So since this particular agri produce has gained world market, I'm sure it must be boring for some people. Give me a little time. Another 5-10 minutes. So they have got access to world markets. That led to further development, agrarian development, farmers are becoming rich, and in fact maize was fetching more rates than rice. It also has brought airport. So ports also are bringing infrastructure. And then?
Increase foreign reserve currency.
Absolutely correct. It will also bring the features, not a foreign exchange. Fantastic point. Then? That's more urbanization related rather than food related, no? Let's discuss if it's not correct, I would say. It could be a corollary at a much, much later stage, but not exactly direct benefit of a port. After some time it will happen. Once port comes, then a city will come. After city comes, then you come out with new concept of smart city or dumb city or whatever. Then,
reduce price of commodities.
Yes, that's a good point. It will reduce prices of commodities. Your poor can be serviced better. Your poor need not the staff.
Entrepreneurship.
Yes, exactly. It will throw off huge amount of entrepreneurship opportunities. Fantastic point. It will throw off a lot of opportunities. Then, one more, last. Okay, let's conclude. I think some people are hungry and some people are bored also. Now, I think all the points which I thought I can share with you, you are answered. There is no need for me or your professors to be why APCM has adopted portnet
deck. It's taken up by Samipa concept.
Machipatnam port has not started. First, the port has to start.
My question is that you have mentioned that many more villages are asked, requesting CM to adopt our villages also. You have given better CM policy is followed in Machipatnam port. There won't be any issues in land acquisition or starting up because it is taking almost 6 to 7 years time to build the port.
That's a good question, but the reason is 4,800 acres of land. So there are a lot of government acquisition procedures. Private sector cannot directly go on extra land. It can unofficially buy a big surface of land here and there. Officially it can't buy. So government has to acquire and give us, and one is agricultural lands acquisition, second is village acquisition. So at the time of village acquisition, this is a PPP project where as per the agreement, government will acquire. This port is, let me tell you, we are only operators, it is owned by government of AP. After concession period, it has to be transferred to government of AP. Similarly, that is also owned by government of AP. They will have to buy the land and transfer to us. And at that time, we become a partner to them and then build the through our CSR activities. Right now, I can't go and do that. So government didn't have the clarity how to take it forward. Only now, government has come out with a policy of not only a port, we will develop an industrial city at Machipatnam. For that, we require 30,000 acres of land. And government, since they don't have money, they have come out with similar policies like capital region acquisition. So they are going to have a land pooling system. Once they start pooling the land, then we will go and then we will start building the port, and then we will also identify who are the actual villages who are affected. Then all these activities again have to be done through the government. If suppose I build house and give you or him or them, it doesn't work. The beneficiaries have to be listed out, identified, otherwise by tomorrow there will be 1,000 huts coming there.
All the politicians will go and put up huts there. You understand? So it has to be enumerated who are the actual landowners, who are the actual householders, how many people are living in each village, which land has to be acquired, which land should not be acquired, right? Which village should be acquired, which village should not be acquired, which village should be displaced, which village should not be displaced. These are all very, very important decisions to be made by the government. Private sector cannot make that. Right? So all those decisions are pending. Once those decisions happen, then we and government jointly will go and address their concerns. Right now we can't go. Thank you. It will be positive impact only, it will not be negative impact. It is creating more economy. In fact, I will show you one slide. It will create huge positive impact on Indian economy.
But it will be concentrated only on one part, only in question of support, the economy will be concentrated. But it's it will be a loss for the other states as well, sir.
Which states?
Like Orissa, Bengal and all.
See, there is something called APCM starts worrying about Orissa state, he can't deliver to his people, right? Orissa state has to worry. Any Nellore collector should not worry about Vaidar collector. Nellore collector should worry about Nellore and its development and the people, right? So, competitive federalism is the order of the day. Other states also will learn. Like, for example, because of competition from Krishnapatnam, Chennai port and New port are also improving. So, only way to take this country forward is to showcase good practices. Learn from other states or other countries, other good practices and create a competition through which they will also improve. Otherwise, 12 or 14 laggard ports will ruin our economy. So it is important that there is competition between ports. Today what happens, government porters chairman also goes and meets people and organizes trade meets. Earlier, to get the appointment of a government porters chairman is like almost only after Sabarimala and the Tirupati gods. Next is this God. It's so difficult to get appointed. That type of bureaucracy was there. Now, CEOs, chairman, they all go to colleges, schools, then they do marketing of their boards, including government boards. So it has brought the change already. So it will only improve economy, it will never destroy economy. But maybe yes, there will be disparities of growth. So we have to create more boards and then they have to maybe develop. Thank you.
That there is a chance for to grow as entrepreneurs. If any student wants to start like an entrepreneur, like starting their own customer sourcing agency or anything logistics and shipping sector, is the government is really supporting and the factories are really supporting in Andhra Pradesh or the East Coast area to start like that? And what are the suggestions you would offer to grow as an entrepreneur?
Yeah, government of India as well as government of AP, now they are very proactive on this. In this area, for example, Government of India Prime Minister visits a startup. If you read the policy, there are a lot of incentives for a budding entrepreneur, and they are going to give total clearances in no time. Sometimes they are saying no clearances, no taxation. Go and start your own, and then coupled with that, lot of seminars and discussions are happening for CII, FAPSI, AP Chamber of Commerce, so many such industrial bodies are also organizing workshops for the budding entrepreneurs to support them. Banks are also ready to give loans. And then there are a lot of Skill India programs which are ready to train your employees. So a lot of such programs are happening. People have to be alert and see what type of programs are there, which business is better, in which area you want to be. Even CHS, now we have an exclusive customs commission rate for the entire coast of AP, other than Vizag City, because already Vizag City has supported, and now more than 20 new CHS are coming in Krishnapatnam, all young boys. So they are all working, they are all learning, and more than 500-600 people are working in this area, CHS. I think you should be slightly bigger, you should become an exporter or importer or an investor.
Thank you.
Yeah, but things are happening.
Thank you, sir. Request our legal director to present the momentum, sir. we are looking forward to more sessions.